Romare Beardon was an African-American artist, author, and songwriter. Born on September 2nd in 1911 in North Carolina, he moved to New York City when he was 3 years old. His mom worked for a black newspaper, and their home became a meeting place for artists and musicians of the Harlem Renaissance art movement. Many of his collages feature musicians, and today we're going to make a drawing of a bass player. If you're not familiar with what a bass player does, here's some video of bass player Willie Dixon, who was alive about the same time as Romare Beardon, and they probably enjoyed each other's company. So as we draw along, we can listen to some great bass playing jazz music. I am noticing that these how to draw directions usually have your paper divided into fourths. So I'm folding my paper on one side, and then I'm folding it the other way, and I'm going to end up with two lines that cross just like those pink dotted lines in the directions. I'm going to keep things super light up at the top. I'm going to be drawing the very top of the bass and the very bottom of the bass. And I'm just kind of figuring out where everything needs to go. By the way, when I start to work on these straight lines, I'm reflecting and realizing that I needed to move the neck of the bass over a little bit. And now I'm going to include four strings, even though the directions only show three, because a bass does have four strings. I'm letting my whole wrist, my whole arm touch the paper as I pull it down, and that helps me make my lines kind of straight. They don't need to be super straight. If I look at the directions, I notice that just above that line is where the body of the bass starts. So we're gonna draw just a little background of the neck there. And now I'm gonna think about that big bass body. I can make a little mark to say, this is where I'm aiming to draw. That's where it seems to dip in. I'll keep my finger there, and that's gonna help me plan ahead. I can see where I want it to end, and I dropped my finger way down to do that. I'll do the same thing over here. I'll put my finger in the place where I want to dip in, and then I can follow along to the bottom. Anytime you wanna pause and fix anything about your drawing, please do so. I'm looking at the next part, and it seems to be the openings in the bass that allow that great sound to come out. I bet Mrs. Taylor knows what these are called. I would have to look it up. But they look a little bit like the letter C. If I keep following, there's this little piece underneath. Looks a little bit like a rainbow. Now I'm gonna start what might be the challenging part, and that is the body of the bass player. So notice how I use my finger to help me figure out, oh, where am I going? I love using those two cross lines because that helps me remember where I need to be to make my drawing work. Now, one leg is going to show, but I bet you've figured out that this musician's other leg is behind his bass, so we're not going to see it, and we're not going to have to draw it. I'm looking at the bass player's hand, and I'm noticing that the person who designed this drawing just makes a little cuff of a sleeve. See how I'm using my fingers to kind of figure out where do I want everything? Again, pause the video if you want to catch up. Wow, that looked like a big letter L. I'm going to start his head, and I'm a little bit nervous about drawing his head. I don't feel as confident about drawing faces because I don't think I practice them often enough. But I'm going to do my best to copy what the person who designed the drawing has done. I think I'm going to end up making some adjustments here. I'm going to draw the mouth of the player, and his nose goes up. And then I didn't give his head a very good shape, so I'm going to change the shape of that head. There's a nice V for his jacket, and he's got lapels on his shirt, and then there's a necktie in there. Here come the hands. So there's a cuff of the shirt, and then I notice the fingers come out as a straight line and circle back. And then only two fingers are playing, and the other fingers would just be lumps. Looks a little small, but I'm gonna keep going. There's another hand up here, and this hand just looks like a great big swoop. And I'm gonna lightly put in that swoop. Then I'll go back and darken in the parts of it that I like. There's that cuff again. And then this hand is shaped a lot differently because it's just pressing down on those strings. So it's more like a design of a hand than a real looking hand. I think this hand should be bigger, so because I'm still working in pencil, I can go back and make those changes. And I can change a little bit about his head. I think I'm going to make the shape of the top different. It's really great to be able to reflect on your work and decide where you want to make changes. So I'll go back in now, and I'm going to look and see, is there anything I want to erase or change before I start coloring? And yes, I wasn't very happy with this opening. I'm going to change that a bit and make it a little bit thinner. I'll erase the strings in his hands, I'll erase that top of the body, and I'll clean up the head a little bit. And once I feel like my drawing is pretty clean, I'm gonna start to color. And for this, I'm just gonna use crayons. Doing some speed coloring here. And please remember, you do not have to do the same colors that are on the illustration. Maybe you could end up with a pink base. I bet there is such a thing. Or maybe your base is going to be blue. With my black crayon, I'll fill in the openings in the body of the base. And because we've been talking about value in some of my classes, I'm gonna put a little bit of a highlight on that piece on the bottom. See that little white stripe I'm leaving? Kind of shows where light would hit it. I'm gonna darken in my strings, and just like before, I'm gonna have my whole arm on the table as it pulls down. Helps me keep my strings kind of sort of straight. I kind of like it when they're a little bit wobbly. So when it comes to coloring in the skin, I would consider using two or three different crayon colors, because right now there's not enough contrast with the base that I picked, but if I mix brown and black together, I can get a nice, rich skin tone for my bass player. I like to do the brown first because it helps me get a good base color in, and then when I go back in with the black on top of that, I know how hard I want to press so that I can get just the tone that I'm looking for. So the only skin that's showing is his head and his two hands. When I go to color a suit, I'm remembering, I saw that little extra line. I'm remembering something I used to do as a kid. I used to really enjoy putting an outline on things before I filled them in with coloring. And I don't know why, but it just always made me feel a little more comfortable. And in this case, it might be a great way to make the suit stand out. Oh my goodness, I've really sped up the film now. You will probably want to pause the video so that you can catch up with this wild coloring. Because Romare Beardon usually did collages, he would have big areas of just plain color that were made from other papers. There goes the necktie. The collar of the shirt shows. Oops, and I forgot the very top of the base. You can do whatever you'd like for a background. I'm going to copy what the designer of the drawing did, just to show you how great it is when the whole background is filled with color. You can pick whatever colors you want to do for this. I would suggest not doing brown or black, but look at how great it looks when you fill in the back with color. I really enjoyed drawing with you today, and I hope that you've enjoyed listening to this great jazz music with all these bass players. Maybe you can look up some other jazz music to draw or paint to.